this is the tangent, not to be confused with tantric. A tangent is like something that goes off from the main body, a tertiary item. They began in 2002 as a one-off supergroup. They have instead released 10 albums of prog. Andy Tilson of Parallel, or 90s, began the project, and he is still at it, and he is the only original member left. Artist Ed Unitsky, a specialist in prog sleeve art, has done 5 of the sleeves for the tangent, and they are wonderful. An award-winning specialist, winning best artwork in the 2003 Dutch Progressive Rock Page poll. And they have that in Holland. Tangent has had 11 different drummers, 5 different keyboardists, and 5 different bass players. Here's the album. 1. The Music That Died Alone in 03. This is Hammond B3 driven with a saxophone. Nothing saxophone. 2. The World That We Drive Through in 04. Musical Stories, but not bestsellers. 3. A Place in the Queue in 06. The Breakthrough, I guess. 4. Not As Good As the Book in 08. It's got a lot of piano moods. 5. Down and Out in Paris and London in 09. Imagine that's a live album. I'm not sure. 6. Calm in 2011. Dreary Reiteration of Yes's Throwaways. 7. Le Sacre du Travail. And 13. This is also quite good. 8. The Spark in the Ether. And 15. And this is not also as good. 9. The Slow Rust of Forgotten Machinery. In 17. And this album sounds exactly what its name sounds like. 10. Foxy in 18, and it's pretty good. So this band has a good album and a not so good album and a good album and a not so good, you know. 11. Auto Reconnaissance in 20. Tower of Babel video, not very interesting. This is why prog sucks sometimes. And the sleeve art truly is amazing. All like a different oil painting, museum quality. That's the one problem with not having an LP. All of your audio is reduced to a smaller size, and the sleeve art is also reduced. But in this case, it's worth it. Check it out. Just don't get one of those off-year albums. Get one of the ones that was good.